What's up, vapers? This is Spin Fuel's Daily Vape TV. My name is Nick, and today we're going to be checking out the Council of Vapor Aris Pro Rebuildable Dripping Atomizer. Before we go any further, I just want to give a huge shout out to EV Liquids. They're the ones that sent me this device for the purpose of review. So the reason you're seeing this thing first right here on Spin Fuel's Daily Vape TV is all because of EV Liquids. Make sure you check out their website. I'll have a link in the description for you. Before we get started, I want to just give you a little bit of information on what's new on this one compared to the regular Aris dripping atomizer. The Aris Pro has an enhanced wider airflow. They've essentially added about a third more airflow to this device, as well as a longer, taller post in here. They have also drilled out that middle airflow section a little bit more, so you get more air to your coils. I think that's one of my main problems with the previous version, was that there was not quite enough air to the coils, and they seem to have remedied that situation, so good job on that. A few other things I want to mention about this device: they have also added better glass to the cap right here, so it's a little bit more durable. I did see a few people have a few issues with their glass caps. They do also offer a replacement on the EVE eLiquids website if you need a new glass cap for it, so head on over there if you need one. But on the Pro version, you're going to get a little bit better glass on it. The gold-plated posts are the same as in the last version, and they are machined right into the deck, so you're never going to have a post spin on you, which is awesome. It also has a gold-plated 510 connection. Other than that, though, it's pretty similar to the original Aris dripping atomizer, and as you can see here, I've got it sitting on the Kindred 1.5, which I'll be doing a review of very shortly, so keep an eye out for that as well. Let's take a couple rips off of this thing and get to the close-ups. Alright, let's get to the close-ups right after this. Alright, so here you can see the Aris Pro Rebuildable Dripping Atomizer by Council of Vapor. Really nice wood veneer kind of looking box, just like the other Council of Vapor products. On the top here, we have a tamper-proof seal, so you know that when you get it, nothing's happened during shipping, no one's been messing with your device. And some writing on the back there. That's the Council of Vapor's Facebook page and their website. So I don't know if you can really even see that, but has a nice kind of embossed print to it. And let's go ahead and take off the cover, show you what's inside the box. So there we go. As you can see, it comes with the Aris guide here. Just gives you a quick setup guide, all the parts. And I believe this is exactly the same as the first version, especially because it doesn't say Aris Pro, it only says Aris, so I'm guessing they kind of reused that. But essentially it's the same, so there you go. And as you can see here, we have the atomizer itself. Let's go ahead and take that out. Show you a little closer look here. So there's the atomizer itself. We're actually going to put that aside for a sec and show you what's in the bottom. Hopefully you can see in there a little bit, but they give you, oops, there you go, you can see the screws, extra O-rings, little baggie of tools. So there you go. Alright, so let's get rid of this packaging and show you some close-ups of the device itself. Here you can see I've broken down the atomizer into the different pieces, and we're just going to go one by one from top to bottom. First, I'll show you the drip tip. Same drip tip as the previous version. single O-ring, but it definitely is not loose in there. It takes quite a bit of force to put it in and take it out, so it's never going to fall out on you accidentally. Pretty chunky glass, not such a wide bore, but it's pretty decent. You know, for a flavor chasing atomizer, it should be very sufficient. And that's pretty much all there is to say about that. Next we have the center glass top cap piece here. And if you can rotate around here, there we go. As you can see, it says Aris Pro. Really nice subtle engraving over the stainless steel, kind of a brushed stainless finish, and it matches the Kindred 1.5 really nicely, so kudos to COV for that. The glass in here doesn't say on the website whether it's Pyrex or not. I don't believe it's advertised as Pyrex, but it's pretty tough glass. It's decent. They have beefed it up a little bit. I'll show you in a few seconds a comparison between the standard glass and the Aris Pro glass, so hold tight for that. We'll get to that in a second. I believe this glass is fused in this top cap section here. I believe it's glued in. I'm not exactly sure. I have heard other people say that it is glued in, but I'm gonna have to take their word for it. But there is replacements available on the Eve eLiquids website. Alright, so here's what you guys really came to see. This is the base section to the atomizer itself, and as you can see, these posts here are all 24 karat gold plated. The negative posts are drilled directly into the base of the atomizer, so they're never going to spin on you. The center hole of this airflow control system has been bored out a little bit more, which I'll show you in greater detail when we compare it to the regular Aris atomizer. And the positive connection, still the same, three post dripper in a slightly different configuration than most drippers, I should say. Big chunky insulator on the bottom there. Here's your two O-rings that hold the glass cap on. I don't think they're as chunky as the previous version, but we'll go over that in a little bit when we compare them. And the airflow control system. Hopefully, let me see if I can get you a little bit closer. Again, this is just an improved version over the standard Aris atomizer. Slightly wider Cyclops eye here, and it is fully adjustable. One thing I wish they would have done is maybe made a few notches in it so that you can click it into place. As of right now, it just kind of spins freely, and if you do knock it around a little bit, you can close it off by accident. So hopefully you guys can see that. And the base of the atomizer, let's see, has the Council of Vapors logo on it, which is really cool looking. The engravings are subtle, but definitely cool looking in my opinion. Kind of gives it this like old school kind of look to it. It's a little busy, but you're probably never gonna see it, so it's no big deal. And there's your 510 connection, which is also gold plated. Alright, so let's just put this thing all back together. Alright, here's the atomizer all put together. Really, you know, attractive looking atomizer. I mean, it's definitely going to turn some heads if you're out and about and you're vaping on this thing. Just watching the center section fill up with vapor is just so cool. Little bummer though, because it does fog up pretty easily. And after a few rips, you know, you can see a lot of the droplets forming on the outside, but one pro to this atomizer, this style atomizer, is it's never going to leak. I've filled this thing up with almost 2 mils of e-liquid, and it runs right down the walls when you tip it from side to side. The only way it's ever going to leak is if you tilt it all the way upside down, so that's definitely a good thing in my book. All right, so that is the Aris Pro RDA. Let's compare it quickly with the standard Aris. All right, so on the right you can see the Aris Pro. On the left you see the standard Aris RDAs, and they are identical in height and identical in width. They're both 22 millimeters in width, and the drip tips on them are exactly the same. The glass on the Aris Pro is a little bit chunkier, and we'll be able to see that once we take the top caps off. The engraving is slightly different on these two atomizers. Personally, I prefer the standard Aris. I mean, it's just a matter of personal preference, but I just wanted to show you guys so you could see the difference. And let's go ahead and take off the top caps for both. And again, the Aris Pro is on the right and the Aris is on the left. It's a little bit hard to tell with the way that I have the lighting set up, but looking at it directly, I can tell that the glass is a little bit chunkier on the Aris Pro version as compared to the Aris. As far as the, you know, chemical composition of the glass, I'm not sure if there's any difference whatsoever, but I can definitely tell that the Aris Pro is slightly chunkier. So I think that's what they really improved on. As far as any other differences in these caps, I really can't tell. I can't see any difference. The drip tips are identical. They're the same exact height. They look like they say have the same bevel on them. The only difference is the chunkier glass on the Pro versus the standard Aris. And once again, I have the Aris on the left here and the Aris Pro on the right. And you can see the size difference in the Cyclops eye here and the airflow control. Both of these, or neither of these, have any sort of clickiness to the airflow control ring. They just spin really freely. So like I said, if you knock it a little bit, then you're going to find that your airflow might have been shut off. So keep an eye on that. Hopefully you can see the center post on these atomizers. Pretty dramatic difference as far as size. On the Aris Pro, it's much taller. It's actually the equivalent of the negative post with the screw on it as compared to sunk below the screw on the standard Aris, as you can see here. And that's just going to help you direct your airflow more towards your coils. And it's going to be a little bit easier to build on. You're going to have a little more building freedom with the Pro version over the standard Aris. And obviously the hole that's drilled in it is much larger, so you're going to direct a lot more air coming through the atomizer towards your coils, which is definitely a big plus in my book. And that's pretty much it as far as the major differences between these two atomizers. Let's go back to the main screen, have a vape real quick, and talk about it some more. All right, so you just saw the close-ups, and now let's get to some pros and cons. My first pro is going to be the price. Now I'm just speculating here because I don't know exactly what the price point is going to be for this thing when it does come out, but I imagine it's going to be similar to the standard Aris dripping atomizer. So that is selling now for $50 on Eve's website. So if this comes in around that price point, it's definitely going to be a pro. You know, you don't find too many atomizers around this price for this type of quality. So for that, it gets a pro in my book. My second pro is going to be the larger airflow hole in the deck section here. I really think that does help as far as the air going to the coils. We'll get to the rest of the airflow control system a little bit, but for now, the center post is definitely a pro. And the third pro is going to be the better glass. I never had a problem personally with my glass on my standard Aris, but I know I saw a few people complaining about it, but I've never had a problem, and this one should even hold up better. So there you go, thumbs up. And let's get to the cons. My first con is going to be the airflow control system in general as far as the size. This is definitely marketed more towards your flavor chasing. So if you guys are cloud chasing out there and you think this is going to blow huge, massive clouds, you're wrong. Sorry, sorry to disappoint you, but I have this built at a 0.4 dual 26 gauge build, so it's nothing too crazy, and it gives you really good flavor, and there's also vertical coils, and I have them set up directly in front of that air hole. So for flavor, this is definitely a good atomizer. As far as cloud chasing, definitely not. It's nowhere near the airflow of, say, the Atlantis. So if you're kind of looking for that, it's going to leave you a little bit wanting. They definitely did make a big improvement over the first version, but I still want more. If they could get it to the size of the Atlantis, you would be able to chase massive clouds on this thing. I would be really impressed. So who knows, maybe in a future version, they're going to just have this massive airflow on this thing. But for now, it is better than the original version, but it's still a con in my book. My second con is going to be the O-rings on the bottom piece of the atomizer here. The O-rings on the drip tip are just fine, you know, really, really sticky. They're definitely, you know, this thing definitely won't come out on you. It takes a lot of force to get that drip tip out, as you saw in the close-ups. But I had this thing sitting on my vanilla before I actually received the Kindred, and I would just pick it up by accident by the drip tip or the top cap here, and it fell. So kind of wish they added a little bit more chunky O-rings on this thing. Hopefully the final version will come out with a little bit thicker O-rings on there, and definitely make sure they're wiped really free of any juice before you put your top cap back on, because that'll also cause them to slip off a little bit easier. So finally, would I purchase this device if I didn't receive it for free for the purpose of review? And my answer would be yes and no. Since I have the original Aris, I wouldn't really find this necessary to upgrade for the minor improvements. I really don't have a problem with the first version of the Aris. It's definitely a flavor chasing atomizer, and I know that and I understand that, so I build it to suit. But as far as if I wanted a brand new atomizer that's for flavor chasing, that had moderate airflow, I would purchase it. So yes and no. You know, I don't feel that it's really necessary to upgrade if you're already an Aris owner. Don't think it's really necessary to take that leap and step up and purchase this one. But if you're buying it for the first time, yeah, give it a shot, definitely. I did want to mention a few things. Obviously, in my first video, I've said that the gold con attacks, the gold 510 connection would give you a better conductivity because of the material, and I was wrong. Gold is not the most conductive material known to man. Definitely wrong about that, so I do apologize. And also, I've seen a lot of you complaining about me calling it K-Fun style. And the only reason I called it K-Fun style is because there was really no other buzzword to mention the type of airflow that this has. Now you see atomizers like the Geyser and the Kennedy RDA and things like that that have the bottom airflow, and that's definitely more of an appropriate word for it. But now, you know, you definitely have a different style atomizer for what this can, you know, what can describe this. So those are the only two things I really wanted to fix from my previous video. Other than that, make sure you stay tuned for my live stream. It's happening New Year's Eve. So Wednesday the 31st, I'm going to be live streaming at 8 p.m. right here on www.youtube.com/dailyvapeTV. So make sure you head to my channel at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Wednesday. If you want to catch my live stream, I'm just going to be talking about the year in review and just kind of going on. And, you know, if you guys feel like chatting in the chat box, go for it. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, guys. That about does it for this review. Don't forget to check out www.spinfuel.com for lots more of my videos, as well as the Smokin' Joey and the Vapor Trail channel. Don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. And as always, vape on!